Stop wasting your money randomly boosting your Facebook posts to completely cold audiences.
Creating custom audiences in Facebook is the most effective way to use Facebook advertising.
So let's jump into Facebook!
Okay, so you might recognize this screen. This is your ads manager. This is where if you click to create an advert on Facebook, this is where it's going to take you, okay? Place where you can start to create your very own audience based on things like location, other demographics, the likes, interests, all this kind of thing. But this isn't the actual place where we want you to create your custom Facebook audiences. Where we actually want you to go is to your ads manager, and then go and click on audiences all the way up here. This is a dummy account, so this is what it will look like if you literally don't have anything and it's not been set up before. And what you can see here is custom audiences. This is what we want. And here's all the options that you can do.
Pretty good.
Firstly, you can create an audience based off a customer file. What does that mean? Basically means that you can upload your email addresses to Facebook, and it will match those email addresses to Facebook accounts, which you can then target your ads to.
Now that is pretty cool. This is really great if you want to serve ads to your current email list or certain subsets of your email list. For example, you might have a list within your email list of people that have clicked to see a specific sales page or a specific promotion that you're running. Mm-hmm. You can upload that subset to Facebook through this custom audience, and you can create an ad to be served just to them.
Awesome! What you can even do is take your email list and then upload it to Facebook and make a lookalike audience, whereby Facebook will find people that are similar to your existing email list.
That is how you do it! The second way you can create a custom audience is by creating a list of people who have visited your website or took specific actions whilst on your website.
Mm-hmm.
Now, there is a little bit of a technical setup here, so you will have to put a pixel on your website, which is just a tiny, tiny bit of code.
Boom!
So all you have to do is put this tiny little bit of code in the header tag of your website. This will then tell Facebook who is going on your website and what pages they are going on.
Show me that again, Pete.
This is a really easy task that either you can figure out or your web developer can do in like 5 minutes.
And now we can start creating audiences of people who have been on your website in the past so many amount of days. Or if we select this little drop down, we can see people who have visited specific web pages but not others. And we can even target people by the amount of time they've spent on certain pages.
This is extremely, extremely valuable for if you want to retarget and serve ads to people that have been on specific pages on your website. For example, your checkout page. And what you can also do is exclude people who have been on the thank you page. So it only targets people that have actually been to buy, but not actually pressed. Yes, I'm going to buy this. So cart abandonment, basically.
The third is through app activity, so we can create audiences of people who have done specific actions with your app. But moving on swiftly, our favorite way to create custom audiences is through people who have engaged with your page and your content on Facebook or Instagram.
Oh yeah.
So if we click through on that, you can see there's multiple ways we can create these types of audiences as well. So the first one here is video, and what we can do is click and choose for what percentage of video we want people to have watched. So let's just say 50%. And then we choose the videos. And what you can do is just check off videos that you have posted natively to your Facebook page or your Instagram business profile, which is pretty cool too. So let's just say these three videos. So what it's gonna do is create an audience of people who have watched 50% of your video and above, which is really, really cool. And then you can give that a name and a description. We'd highly, highly recommend you giving these extremely descriptive names, mm-hmm. because otherwise it starts to get very complicated. If you go back, you can also create audiences from lead forms. So if you've been creating a list of people that have opened or completed a form in your ads, your lead ads, you can retarget to them too. You can also create an audience of people that have engaged with and opened your canvas on Facebook.
Show it!
you can create an audience of people that have interacted with your Facebook page and now your Instagram business page, which is yet another reason to upgrade your Instagram account to a business profile. So there you have it. Those are the five engagement types of ways that you can create custom audiences here in Facebook. Let's recap.
This is often much better than serving ads to a completely cold audience because you know they have interacted with your business or your brand some way previously.
So now when we jump into Ads Manager and go to create an ad, when it comes to our ad set and our audience, we can actually jump over and choose from all of our custom audiences that we've just created.
Hope you enjoyed that, everybody. Please remember to subscribe to our channel and share this video if you've learned something new today. Also, you might want to check out this video over here. Mm-hmm. It's all about how to create leads and sales from your blogs, and you may just need some of those handy custom audiences to do just so.
Oh yeah. He's been Andrew, I've been Pete, and we'll see you next week. Bye.